fix this microphone this way? Who fixes this microphone this way? Does Jackie Cahoon do that? Whatever his name is. Jerky Cahoon? No, who does this? Now look, I'm 6'1" and a half, you know. That's the son of a bitch. He's 6'3" and a half. I gotta have it done like this. My engineer's dying up in the booth. These microphones cost $2 and a half each. Do what? JD's mics go 2.5. Well, I know that. You can't tell me that. But he got them on sale. They're a quarter each. It's like them suits you got for the group. Lansky Brothers on Beale Street.
I've never done it either. I've never done it myself. It's the first time, Jack, right here. You know, I'm game. Come on, come in. I think I'm going to turn me off. I'm going to turn you off. Sound like some of the first records I ever made.
Well. Well. One minute. Was that note right? Check. Just check it, JD. What is a note? E. Four keys and one piano. Okay. Marty, help us out in case we need you. Now, listen, I'm doing this in falsetto bass voice. Just like people have falsetto high voices, or tenor voices. Like Cheryl and a couple of the guys up here on stage can do the high falsetto thing. I've learned a trick. And it's a trick bass voice. JD does it in natural voice sometimes. And I do it in the false bass voice. And we have the trombone guy to do it in case we miss it. All three of us sometimes. Well, I said I got a woman way across town. He's good to me. Ooh, yeah. I said I got a woman way on the mountain. I got a woman way good to me. Oh, yeah. Good joke, you know. Here comes. Good to me. You say you love early in the morning. This one. Oh, yeah. Say you love early in the morning. This one. Daddy love me all day and night. Look at all the buses in the streets of life. Running streets, leave me alone. Don't you don't play like that. And I got a woman, hey, girl, say, good to me, yeah. Yeah, I got a woman, hey, girl, say, good to me, yeah. She's all right. She's all right. She's all right. She's all right.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
boom, boom, boom. Amen. Work on it.
Amen.
Amen. One more time.
Let me see if it all works on him. One leg, you see. Smooth, baby. That was a smooth ride. Tell me what I want you to do. I want you to take me down to treetop level in a B-52 and stall out and then start the engines back up. You got it? Okay. Amen. 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 Take your time, baby. Gentlemen, my name is Bill Cosby. Elvis closed last night. I'm a little lighter skinned than you thought I was, and I don't have a natural light like I do on my TV show, you know. Me and old Harold, I mean, not Harold, what's his name? Albert. Fat Albert. Hey, 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 look, look, look. Somebody gave me this thing here. Yeah, it really is. Somebody gave it to me. And I just got an 8th degree black belt in karate. After 16 years of doing this art every day for 16 years, I was awarded the 8th degree, which carries, let's see, 8th degree. There's only 10 degrees of black. So the 8th degree I just got this week, the 9th degree carries senior master of the art, the next one, and the 10th is senior grandmaster of the art. So that's where I got to strive to go to, which takes quite a while, isn't it? Until it's time for you to go. You're not a dream, you're not an angel, you're a woman. I'm not a king, I'm just a man. Take my hand, we'll make a space in your teeth and his life every plan. And he will stay till it's time for you to smack. Yes, we're different, worlds apart, we're on a fish, not the same. We love and hurt at the start, like in a game. Thank you. You could have stayed outside my heart, hello, Jim. Here I'll stay till it's time for you to go. This love of mine, it's a rough way to make a living, boy. No beginning, there's no beginning. I was an oak, that's a joke, aren't I? You could have stayed outside my heart, but in your dreams, you'll stay till it's time for you to go. This love of mine has no beginning, has no end. Oh, Lord, Lord, I was a oak, I'm a willow, and I can be the Lord. And though I'll never in my life see you again, still I stay this time for you to go. Oh, yes, I'll stay till it's time for you to go. Oh, oh, oh. Thank you very much. You're a good audience. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You're fantastic, really. Thank you. You got it, baby. Take it out. You came when I was happy, and your sunshine grew to love you more each passing day. For too long, I built my world around you, and I prayed you'd love enough of me to stay. So if you love me, let me know. If you don't,
let me go. The arms are open wide, the home is closer
to my love.
The hands that run their fingers through my head.
Same.
The smile says hello. It's good to see you. Anytime I turn around, you'll find me there. There's nothing so much more than making me love you. What else can I do to make you see? You know you have a heaven.
Song, ladies and gentlemen, that we have coming out in about 2 weeks. I hope you like it. It's called It's Midnight.
Maybe it's too late, and I sometimes even hate myself for loving you. Trying to be strong, the nighttime comes along, and I start wanting you. What are you?
Listen, so
where is all my self-control? I'm burning when I'm in my soul, needing you. Wishing I could be the man I tried to. Hating me for wanting to be with you. Knowing you don't love me. But it's midnight, oh Lord, and I miss you. It's getting late, and I know that's when I am weak. But if nothing, I'm awake, I'm looking so much brighter in the daylight. It's getting late, and I know that's when I am weak. But it's all things I'm away, looking so much brighter. It's midnight. and I miss you.
My reason for living.
she took my small baby boy.
Oh, and this time, Lord, you gave me a mountain. A mountain. Lord, you know I may never fly. In love, Lord, in here, Lord, in love. Oh, yeah.
You're a beautiful audience. Thank you. Thank you very much. Just a second. You're fantastic. Thank you. That's beautiful. Thank you, man. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. That's fantastic, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. I want to make one thing clear. Let me make something clear. I've been singing that song for a long time. Just a minute here. I've been singing that song for a long time. And a lot of people kind of got it associated with me because they think it's a personal name. It is not. It's a beautiful song written by Marty Robbins. And I heard Frankie Lane do it, I think it was. And I just love the song. And it has nothing to do with me personally. My ex-wife, Priscilla, she's right here. Honey, stand up. Come out, Johnny. Come out. Come on out. Turn around and let them see you. Let them see you. Boy, she's a beautiful chick, I'll tell you for sure, boy. Boy, I know them when I pick someone, you know. God damn. Now, show my little daughter, Lisa. She's 6 years old. Look at her jump up. Put your dress down, Lisa. You pull your dress down before you jump up like that again, young lady. And then at the same booth is my girlfriend, Sheila. Stand up, Sheila. Turn around. Turn around. Completely around. Sheila, straight up. Hold a ring up. Hold a ring up. The ring, your right hand. Look at that son of a bitch. Now, the thing I'm trying to get across is... we're the very best of friends, and we always have been. Our divorce came about not because of another man or another woman, but because of the circumstances involving my career. I was traveling too much. I was gone too much. And it was just an agreement that I didn't think it was fair to her because I was gone so much and everything. So I, therefore, as decently as you can do that type of thing, we just made an agreement to her to always be friends and be close and care, because we have a daughter to raise, and for her to have whatever she wanted as a settlement. After the settlement, and it came out about $2 million, you know. Well, after that, I got her a mink coat. I know it. I'm talking about the mink coat. You hang loose over there. The XKE Jag after the song, just gave it to her. She got me, listen to this, tonight, a $42,000 white Rolls Royce. That's the type of relationship that we have, you know, and it's not a bad setup, is it, fellas? You know, I mean, I got a part of it back anyway, did I? I wasn't hurting too bad, but I mean, I did get part of it back. You know, she bought the car just out of a gesture of love, and she likes the studs that I have. It's not a car, it's a studs. No. God, Jesus, help me. No, it's called a stud. A studs. And she likes a stud. She likes a studs. Mike Stone ain't no stud, so forget it. She liked his studs. And so I'm going to give her the studs, and she can give me the rope. Stone, but I wish he was a stud, you know. He's a nice guy. I'd like to do a song here, ladies and gentlemen, that is one of the prettiest goddamn love songs I've heard in my life, man, I'll tell you. No, it is. It's just one of the prettiest songs I've ever heard in my life. I've never sung it. I've never recorded it. I never liked the damn thing until I found out. Damn, I got a toothache. Until I found out the story behind why it was written, and then I really didn't like it because I don't like that type of stuff. So, next song, no. Now, this is a true story of a song. It's been around for a long time. Try to take this belt out, really. It's going to cut me, castrate me, do something, you know. Really, I can't do that. I got things to do and places, you know. Places to go and other tours and things and secret cities and chicks and all that jazz, you know. Look, I just call. Be careful. Be careful, son. Be careful. Don't get it caught in the cord. I'll die, you know. Electrocute my ass. And excuse me, folks. I saw this mumble thing. Oh! Damn, I said, is that tight? You cut off my hair, man. I can't sing. You know, I sing from down in the gut. Any round, two souls. It'll never get up here. I want to tell you a story, if you don't mind, before I do this. So this little young lady right here, her name is Judy Spreckles. And let me tell you a story about her. When I came to Hollywood, I was 20 years old, to do Love Me Tender. Her family was the Spreckles Sugar family. You've heard of those, haven't you? Yeah, well, I guess everybody has because, you know, it's a big company. She gave me Black Star Sapphire ring that I kept up until Priscilla and I were married, and Priscilla used it as an engagement ring. This lady right here did, 20 years ago. Judy Spreckles. I don't know where she's been. She's been married off in the hills, flying in the jets and climbing trees and all kinds of stuff there. Riding horses, she's a wild woman, you know, but she did that, and she comes around every once in a while to check on me. So anyway, let me tell you about this song, all kidding aside. It's the story of a man who's dying in a hospital. And his wife had been sitting by his bedside for 3 days and three nights. Somewhere on the third night, between midnight and day, she lay down beside him and dozed off to sleep softly, Lynn. Lay down beside him and dozed off to sleep. Well, he felt it when she dozed off to sleep. And I hope you'd quit writing the last until I'll tell the story, please. He was dying, and he felt it when she lay down beside him. And he didn't want her to see him pass away. So he took his notepad from the side of the bed, and he very quietly wrote, Softly, I will leave you.
I will leave
softly,
for my heart would break. For my heart would break
if you should wake.
If you should wake
and see me go.
And see me go.
So I leave you.
So I leave you
softly.
Long before you miss me.
Long before your arms can make me stay.
Can make me stay.
For one more hour.
For one more.
For one more day.
For one more day.
He said, after all the years.
After all the years. I can't bear the tears
to fall. So softly.
So softly.
So softly.
I will leave you there. I will leave.
Thank you very much. I couldn't ask for a better audience in the world, believe me. You're out of sight. That was Cheryl Nielsen singing in the background. Fantastic, son. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. God. Okay.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Crying all the time. Well, you ain't never gonna have it and you ain't no friend. You ain't nothing but a hound. Crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound. Crying all the time. Well, you ain't gonna have it and you ain't no friend. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound.
Thank you very much. Well, we lucked out on that deal. I'm not kidding you. Let's do trilogy, okay? Turn the light back up, please. Choke this belt, Charlie. This son of a bitch got a mind of its own, man. I mean, he just crawls where he wants to go, you know. No, leave it alone. Just hook it. Hook it, Charlie. Hook it, wild man. Oh! Not too hard. I had to deal with the bathroom, yeah.
Oh, I wish... Well. Oh, I wish I was in the land of cotton. Old time they are, and I've forgotten. Look away, Lord, look away. Look away, Lord, Dixieland.
Sing it, fellas.
Oh, I wish I was in Dixie.
I wish you were too.
Away. I was born early, Lord, Lord, on frosty morn. Look away, Lord, look away. Look away, Dixieland.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. It's now and ever.
When I first saw you, with your smile so tender, my heart was captured, my soul surrendered. I waited a lifetime, waiting for the right time. Now that you're here, the time is here. Is now or never. Come hold me tight. Kiss me, my darling. Be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be too late. Is now or never. My love will wait. Just like the willow, we require redemption. If we lost true love and sweet devotion, your lips excite me. Your love for who knows when to begin this way.
Thank you very much. Oh, you're out of sight. You are fantastic. Thank you. Boy, I tell you what, really, I couldn't have gotten a better audience if I'd sit out there and paid everybody $20 to come in here. I really couldn't. You are out of sight, boy. I'd like to introduce you to the members of my group before we go any further. First of all, the young ladies you met are in the show tonight. They've been with me for 5 years tonight. Sweet Inspirations. Some of the finest voices in the world, they've been with me 4 years tonight. J.D. Summer and the Stamps Quartet. I'd like to introduce each one of these fellows to you because they're the only ones that don't get introduced with the exception of the big band, and there's too many of them over there, except my friend Giggles over here. Look at him, man. He's jolly. He's jolly, man. And a little Indian, the Indian boy down here. Look at him. Look at this little cat, man. He's turned profile. He was on the head of a nickel. Bill Cosby, he was on the head of a nickel, I'm telling you, man, you know. His grandfather was. Anyway, the singing the baritone from Nashville, Tennessee is Ed Hill. Singing the lead, one of the strongest voices I've ever heard, is Ed Enoch. We over there singing a high tenor, and I mean he's high, boy, he's Bill Bays. The little girl that does her high voice singing, she's with the Metropolitan Opera for a year, and she has a beautiful voice. She works on all my records. Her name is Kathy Westmore. On the lead guitar, ladies and gentlemen, one of the funkiest chicken-picking son of a gun you've ever met in your life, from down in Shreveport, Louisiana, James Burton.
Just pick a little something, James. Just let him, just listen to this dude, man. Listen to him. Go ahead. Talk some more, man. Talk. Stand rock. Stand rock. No jazz. Stand rock. Get a wah-wah, wah-wah. Listen, get a shaft. Guitar from Springfield, Missouri, John Wilkerson. On the drums from down in Dallas, Texas is Ronnie Tutt. Play, Ronnie. Take it off. Take it off. Another baton. Take it off. They fend the bass Duke Bardwell. Play something, Duke. Play it, Duke. Talk to me, son. Talk to me. Play it, Duke. Come on, come on, come on. Walk on it, walk on it, walk on it. Get dirty. Louisiana, man. My alligator's in your hair. Come on. Louisiana, son, alligator bait down there. Come on. Come on. Ah. Even if you got your granny, son. Chuck, 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 chuck. Duke Bardwell. Turn Lindy's amp up. Down in Lubbock, Texas, on the. Turn his amp up. Lubbock, Texas, on the piano, Lindy Harden. Wait there. Alabama, Charlie Hodge. Fellas have been with me for about a year. Cool it for a second. Just hold the music. They've been with me for about a year, and they opened a show tonight, but I'm going to ask them to do a song. Is Pete backstage? Did you do that without you tonight? Would you do that for me? Pete? Pete, are you here? Kid from Sweden, where is he? Come here, son. This guy's from Sweden, ladies and gentlemen, that plays the piano. And I mean, he will make, most of piano players. Hey, hello, Pete. There he is. Hey, you guys do that song, I Know I Couldn't Live Without You. Come on, use my microphone and Charlie's. Okay? Get a Peter mic and use mine and Charlie's. I want them to hear this song. Pete wrote this song, ladies and gentlemen. It's called I Can't Live Without You. He needs a microphone.
Touching you, babe, I've not forgotten.
Cause everything's bringing it by. No, it's just bringing it by. A familiar place, for a familiar place just brings it all by. So much time, you know, everything's bringing it by.
Thank you, man.
Thinking in my solitude, wondering about your attitude, thinking maybe that your love has died. There it is, I can see it in your eyes, and your touch of sweet surrender. With a touch of too much sadness, cause I hurt you so, you know your sorrow shows, and you just can't stay, but you know that you can't let go.
Cause everything's bringing it by, you know it's just bringing it by. A familiar place or a familiar face just brings it all by.
Run the bass.
Everything's bringing it by. Good songs bringing it by. And even after so much time, you know everything's bringing it by. But everything's bringing it by. Good songs bringing it by. And even after so much time, you know everything's bringing it by.
Wait a minute, hold it. Listen to him. Does Pete play Aubrey?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, listen to Shirley one more, and then we'll go on what we're doing, okay? I want him to do a song called Aubrey. This was got by a group called Bread. But they ain't ever sung like this, Cat Hammers.
And Aubrey was a name, but not so very ordinary girl. But who's to blame for a love that wouldn't bloom for the hearts that never played in tune? Like a lovely melody that everyone can see. Take away the words that rhyme, it doesn't mean a thing. And Aubrey was a name. We tripped the night and danced together to the moon. But where's June? No, it never if it did, it never made a sound. Maybe I was absent, I was listening too fast, catching all the words within, the meaning going past. And how I missed a girl, and I'd go 1,000 miles around the world just to be closer to her than to me.
I never knew her.
I never knew her.
But I loved her just the same.
But I loved her just the same.
I loved her name.
I loved her name. Wish that I had found a way, and the reasons I could make her stay.
I've learned a new life.
I have learned a new life.
Apart from all the rest.
Apart from all the rest.
If I can't have,
I can have the one I want,
I'll do without the rest.
I'll do without the rest.
And God.
And God, I must go. And I go 1,000,000 times around the world just to say she had been mine for a day.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, fellas. You're fantastic. And Pete, thank you. It was beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to share with you some of the talent that we have up on the stage here. And, if you dig it, we'll share different things with you, and I'll sing some more songs. And this is our last show. We don't care. These fellas are from Nashville, and I call them Voice. And you see why. Our conductor from Las Vegas is Mr. Joe Gershaw. Joe is conducting the fantastic Joe Gershaw Orchestra. This orchestra, ladies and gentlemen, was voted by Billboard magazine in the last 2 years the number one orchestra of the year. Cost me a fortune to get that done. No, I'm only kidding. There's a guy in the audience. I got sick one night last week, and I had a temperature of about 102. Wait a minute. Don't applaud me 102 temperature. No, I had a temperature. It was a flu going on in this town, and all my employees were dropping like flies. And I was in, they were in a room with me, you know, getting me dressed, and they breathed in my face. And so I caught the flu, and I missed one night, which I don't like to do. I've only missed about 6-7 nights in 19 years from illness. You know, that's because to me, a germ is an enemy, and I hate that son of a bitch, and I'll fight it. You know, and that's why I went to the hospital once in my life. Once in my life. And then it was only for 3 days because they had a little bronchial trouble in the tubes. And they, you know how they do in a hospital, they check you for everything in the world, man. I mean, liver, you know, they'll find something wrong with you. They'll create something if you ain't got it. That guy took a liver biopsy. You know what a liver test is? You know what a liver, you know what it do? The doctor comes in and says, don't look at me. Turns your head. Takes a needle this long, goes right between your ribs, pulls out a piece of your liver. I swear to God, that's it. John, you know what I'm talking about. And so I said, he said, I don't move for 24 hours. And here I was, I guess. Damn, what did he do to me? I was okay. I was getting well, and he come in and stabbed me. I swear to God, I saw him out of the corner of my eye because I can't help it. I'm trained that way. He looked like a samurai warrior. He said, ta-da! Put that needle, man, you know. fastest son I've ever seen in my life. Well, anyway, when I got sick, a fellow volunteered his services to come in and fill in for me. He was way up north somewhere working or getting a TV show. He does so much. He volunteered to come in and work this show for me. And now that he's been here ever since, he'll open here tomorrow night. I'd like to thank him, Bill Cosby. Bill, where are you, buddy? What? Where's Bill? I haven't seen Bill yet. Where's Cosby? You mean after that buildup, that son of a bitch left? Well, the hell with him. I won't pay him anyway. No, I'm only kidding. No, he gets 10 grand. I give him that whether he likes it or not. I stick it up his nose. There's a lady in the audience I'd like to introduce you to. She's been in to see my show twice before. The reason we have a mutual respect is because the only way we know how to sing is from the gut out, both of us. And you know who I'm talking about? Her name is Vicky Carr. Come around, baby. Come around. Come around. There you go. Yeah. Now she's working. You're working where, honey? She's working at the Tropicana. You didn't change. It's okay. Don't make excuses to me. Sit down. No, thank you, Vicky. But anyway, did you hear It's Now or Never? Did you hear the song It's Now or Never? Oh, God, now I got to do it again. It's Now or Never. When I first saw you, with your smile so tender, my heart was captured, my soul surrendered. I waited a lifetime, waiting for you any time. Now that you're here, time is here, and here now or never, how holy time, kiss me, my darling. Be mine tonight. Tomorrow, he'll be here then. It's now or never, my love. Just like a willow, you cry emotion. If we lost true love and sweet devotion, your lips excite me, let your arms invite me. For who knows when we'll meet again this way. It's now or never, come home with time. Kiss me, my darling, be mine tonight. Good morning. Done it once, but we did it again. Oh dear.
Wherever you go, wherever you may wander in your life, surely you know, I always wanna be there, holding your hand and standing by to protect you when you fall. Seeing you through, everything you do.
Make it right.
Yeah, take you to that wonderland that only you can.
Yeah,
all I ask you,
yeah,
Lord, let me be there.
Let me be there.
Watching you grow and going through the changes in your life. That's how I know. I always want to be there. Whenever you feel you need a friend to lean on, here I am. Whenever you call, you know I'll be there.
Yeah, let me be there in your morning. Let me be there in your night.
Yeah,
let me change whatever's wrong and live in my
life.
Make it right.
Yeah,
let me take you to that wonderland. And all you can
share. Yeah,
all I ask you,
oh, let me be there.
Fantastic audience, thank you. Huh. Woo. Okay. Okay, walk in your sleep.
Thank you. see it away. Tell me, what'd you say? Hug in your sleep. I want you, my name.
I want you, my name.
Baby, hug in your sleep. Whatever you say.
Whatever
you say. I want you, my name.
Show
me
my name.
Show me
your my name.
Show me
my name.
Show me my name.
Show me my name.
Hug in your sleep. Don't mention my name.
Don't mention my name. Thank you very much. Lord, have mercy. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like you to meet one of the fellows who promoted me to the 8th degree black. His name is Ed Parker. He has about 18 kenpole schools around the country. Ed Parker. There's another fellow in the audience. See that book. This friend of mine, his name is John Grady. He's written a book. He was head of the narco squad in Los Angeles for 26 years. And on the 166th page, he's got about three pages about me and my ex-wife Priscilla, and about our friendship, and about that maternity suit. Turned out to be a complete conspiracy and a hoax, man. You know, just no way. I had a picture made with that chick, and that's all. I mean, she got pregnant with a camera, a Polaroid or something. Anyway, it's all in this book. It's the most... been watching Polaroid cameras, what? But you know what she did? You know, she goofed up. She named the night, and the night that she named, my wife was with me in the audience. And that's the night she said, ain't no way I'm going to fool around with her out there. You kidding me? So anyway, let me tell you something. If you like things like the French connection, the Chinese connection, the British connection, the knee connection to the jump bone, bone neck to bone, bone neck to. If you like that type of stuff, buy this book. It's called O'Grady. It'll be in print when, John? September 27th. It will fascinate you. It's about 26 years of a hardline policeman working in the narco squad out of Hollywood. So you can imagine what it's like. Buy this book. It's called O'Grady. Okay. John just came back from New York, where he had a meeting of this. I have been a member of this organization for 5 years, the International Narcotics Enforcement Officers Association, in recognition of the outstanding loyalty and contribution to the support of narcotic law enforcement. This award of special honors bestowed upon Elvis Presley in testimony, so-and-so, lifetime member in the International Narcotics Enforcement Officers Association. So I just got that. So, I don't pay attention to rumors. I don't pay attention to movie magazines. They don't read them because they're all junk. And I don't mean to put anybody's job down. I'm talking about they have a job to do and they got to write something. So if they don't know anything, they make it up, you know. So in my case, they make it up. When I hear rumors flying around, I got sick in the hospital. Well, I was, you know, in this day and time, you can't even get sick. You are strung out. Oh, by God, I'll tell you something, friend. I have never been strung out in my life, except on music. When I got sick here in the hotel, I got sicker that one night. I had 102 temperature. They wouldn't let me perform. From three different sources, I heard I was strung out on heroin. I swear to God, hotel employees, Jack, bellboys, freaks that carry your luggage up to the room, people working around, you know, talking, maids. And I was sick. I was, you know, I was getting, had a doctor, had the flu, and I got over one day. But all across this town, I was strung out. So I told him earlier, and don't you get offended, ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking to somebody else. If I find or hear the individual that has said that about me, I'm going to break your goddamn neck, you son of a bitch. That is dangerous. That is damaging to myself, to my little daughter, to my father, to my friends, my doctor, to everybody, my relationship with you, my relationship with up here on the stage. It is dangerous. I will pull your goddamn tongue out by the roots. Thank you very much. Anyway, how many of you people saw the movie Blue Hawaii? Probably the most requested song. Let me get out of this mood. Probably the most requested song in the movie was the Hawaiian wedding song. So let me do that for you. This is the moment I've waited for. I can hear my heart singing.
Blah, 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 blah.
Soon we'll be ringing. This is the moment, love, sweet hello. I will love you long and forever. That's beautiful, honey. Thank you. Promise me that you. I take this and I'm strung out. Honey, you don't mind if I use it to show it, do you? All my love. Thank you, darling. Promise me that you will be me never. I will love you long and forever. Now that we are one, clouds won't hide the sun, blue skies, a Hawaii smile. On this our wedding day, I do love you with all my heart. Oh, 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 yeah. Thank you. Let me show you something for those of you who may not be too observant, and you know, I might have missed. I'm not going to embarrass Kathy, but I'm going to show you what I was doing to her then. She was having to sing on microphone. Come here. No, I want to. So I'm singing. I do love you. Watch my left hand. With all. Watch. My. Oh, that's exactly what I was doing. She had tears in her eyes. Like that. Oh, Lord have mercy. Fantastic. I'd like to thank my engineer, Mr. Bill Porter, who handles all this sound down here. Bill? I'd like you folks to meet my father. He's in the audience somewhere. I'd like him to stand up. Dad, where are you? Daddy, come out here a minute. Come out. There he is. Right there. Thank you, Daddy. My manager, Colonel Tom Parker, where is he? Is the Colonel around anywhere? Oh, he's out, you know, he's out playing roulette. Don't kid me. I know what he's doing. Him and Cosby out there talking mash and drinking trash or whatever. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you a little bit about this jewelry that I got on. No, I can't sing about the jury. Hell, you know, these rocks. Now, this thing I got up wore in the Hawaii special, you know, and people thought it was one big stone, and it's not. It's 11.5 carat stone, which is pretty big, you know. It's the biggest I've ever seen. And anyway, this next to Elizabeth, I think she's got the biggest one. I think you're right. And the biggest diamond, too. You're fast. You're good, boy. This thing here I had designed for the stage. It's got all different shapes of diamonds, pear-shaped, square-shaped, screwball, whatever, you know, so the stage. This I got tonight for you. You know, really. I got it. Just got it tonight, just like I got the suit for closing. And the reason I'm telling you this, and because I think you ought to know it, you help pay for them. Good night. Only fools, only fools rush in. Oh, but I can't help falling in love with you. Yeah, I suppose. Would it be a sin?
Give me that guitar.
Like the river flow, surely to the sea. Oh, my. Darn it. Something's correct. I'm meant to be. Let's do it together.
Take my
heart. Let's do it together. Get ready. It's been 6 months.
I can't help.
Beautiful.
My